Hey y'all, this is Celia the Lice Lady. Welcome back to our channel. Go ahead and subscribe to get more interesting videos on head lice facts, debunking myths, things like that. Today we're going to go through and show you how to pick nits. So let's get started.
So we're gonna start out by just doing a visual check here real quick. We check all the hot spots and see what we have. So if you can see right there, those two dots, those are eggs. Then we're gonna go back here, right there. If you can see that, that's another egg right there. Eggs have a tendency to glisten in light. So if you're confused whether it's an egg or a dandruff, you can always take a flashlight to it and it will show you the glisten to be able to determine what it is. So here at the top of the head, we have several right there. And then another egg right there. So she definitely has it. And I'm not seeing any live bugs at this point. Live bugs are very hard to detect unless there's a lot of them. They like to hide, they don't like light. So those are the eggs. Look at that tiny little baby bug. Do you see that moving? That's a little baby bug. So this is our comb out mousse. I'm just gonna go through. So first you wanna section the hair. You can see that her hair is sectioned. Next you wanna take a little bit of the hair and then you're gonna comb through in all four directions using that comb out mousse to help smooth the hair. We've got links in the description below for the products that we're using and for the comb that we're using. So you're gonna continue to take sections of the hair. The reason why we take sections in the hair is to make sure that we can get the comb through the hair in the most efficient way. Also getting that comb right next to the scalp to make sure if there's anything there that we'll be able to get it, especially those tiny bugs. So make sure that that comb is parallel with the head. That way we can ensure that you're getting the best comb out possible and the best head check possible. When lice lay their eggs, pretend like our hair shaft is a square, but it's actually a circle. So lice are gonna lay their eggs on each side of the hair shaft, only on one side. So it's really important that when we do the head check and when we do the comb outs, that we're combing in all four directions. Once the eggs are removed, it's important to know that lice eggs don't reattach to the hair shaft after they're off. That's a super common question that we get. So don't worry about eggs getting stuck in that comb and getting back onto the head. They're not going to hatch. Also, if they fall onto the floor, they're not gonna hatch also. They have to have the heat of our head in order to be able to survive. Traditionally, the term nitpicking came from just that, picking nits one by one. Sometimes we have to go through and take our fingernails and pick those nits, but typically because we have this type of a comb, we're able to thoroughly comb the hair and effectively have a good treatment. I put a link for this comb in the description below if you want to check the comb out. So when you're going through and doing a head check or picking nits, what you're going to want to do is just go ahead and clean that comb out. Even though those eggs don't reattach, just go ahead and make sure that you give it a good flick with your finger. You can do it over a paper towel. You can also get a cup of water and stick it in the water as well. Either one works. I prefer the comb flicking method with the fingernail. It's like playing a musical instrument.
I know.
So that's basically how you pick nits. I do recommend trying to find a clinic to see if they happen to have one around your area. That way it's super fast, super effective. We can take care of it for you, but if not, you've got your trusty little comb. So you can go ahead and click the link in the description below and see our products that we use for this video. Again, subscribe, comment, like, ask any questions, and we'll be able to answer them for you. Have a happy and lice-free day.